MMA Inside the Cage, presented by Elevation Training Mask.
Welcome back to MMA ITC. Third round action, time to impress the judges. XFC, my favorite promotion, is gearing up for their 25th event, taking it out west for the first time to Albuquerque, New Mexico. It all goes down Friday, September 6th, and it can be found live on AXStv. 25, that's a pretty big deal. It's a milestone, Casey. The company's really come a long way.
It sure is. The XFC takes another big step towards national and international dominance by heading west and securing yet another solid region in Albuquerque, New Mexico. This is something that raises the bar and is definitely setting them apart from their peers within the AXS community.
Well, this card has a lot of juice, and we want to get some picks in and show you a killer main event. Speaking of main events, the main event, a championship bout for the inaugural strawweight title between Stephanie Snowflake Egging, Angela Magana. So what do you think about this fight, Casey? Who do you think takes home the victory?
Well, these two are about to make history as not only the first ladies to head up an XFC card, but they're doing it with the belt on the line, and there's some serious heat between these two. The 11-5 Magana has been around the sport for a long time and has faced a virtual laundry list of the sport's greats. And at first glance, one would think she has it in the bag, but Stephanie Egging has the it factor. Though her MMA record is a mere 3-1, she is a former U.S. boxing team member with tons of experience. And that's not all. This lady has proven to have legit grappling skills, which she showcased in her dominant victory over Heather Clark, as well as her last win over Brianna Van Buren. This is a classic matchup of veteran versus new blood, and I think Egging is on a roll, edging this one out to become the new XFC champ.
I love what Egging brings to the table, but I think Magana might have her number. I'm going to have to disagree with you here. Now, next up, the fight I'm most excited to announce, the sniper Ricky Rainey going to war gets former XFCer and MFC mainstay Diego Lima. What about this fight, Casey?
Ricky Rainey is one of the hottest prospects that XFC has going today. His knockout over Reggie Pena is what highlight reels are made of, and it's hard to discount that 4-fight winning streak that he amassed in less than a year. But this time, he has Diego Lima standing in front of him, who also is on a 4-5 winning streak. This will be a tremendous contrast of styles with a ton of action. I think Rainey is a tremendous athlete and competitor, but I think the pedigree of Lima prevails.
Well, I like the role that Rainey's on. I'm going to take the snipe. We're going to disagree once again. The ladies are back on display as Stephanie Skinner locks horns with Angelica Chavez in an atomweight bout, the scrapper against South Valley Zone. I like Chavez in this fight, but Skinner can definitely go.
Another very equally matched fight. Both have bounced around from promotion to promotion, but have finally landed in one of the sport's fastest growing women's divisions. I give the edge to Chavez in this one. She was part of that Invicta 2 card back in July of 2012, and I think that the big show experience pays off for her.
Hey, we agreed on one. I'm right there with you. Now let's get a couple quick picks here. The tank engine Ryan Thomas looks to extend his streak against undefeated signee Ian Stevens. This could be a fight of the night candidate here. Thomas is the favorite for sure, Kate.
Thomas definitely comes in with a legit record and some serious experience. He's been in there with Ben Saunders twice with Bellator welterweight champ Ben Askren and scored a submission victory over tough alumni Corey Hill back at XFC 21. But don't sell Ian Stevens short. This guy has tremendous wrestling skills and knows how to get on top and stay there. I'm going to give it to Thomas on sheer numbers, but it's not a clean sweep by any means.
Well, I'm going to go with the safe pick. I'm going to go with Thomas on this one. How about Albuquerque's own Joby Sanchez, open fighter tryout winner, matching up against Kentucky's Eric Mell. I think you have to go with Sanchez based on his pedigree. I think Mell's going to be hungry after his loss to Joey Deal at XFC 23.
This one will be lightning fast. Of course, Joby Sanchez finally getting to showcase in his hometown of Albuquerque for the first time since his arrival in the XFC, and I think he will come out with a passion. Now, Eric Mell is a tremendous talent with serious grappling skills of his own. He made a name for himself early on in the Northern Kentucky Cincinnati region. Now he's in there with one of the promotion's premier talents with a chance to do big things. I give the edge to Sanchez, but it's a battle.
We agree on that one as well. Now, many more exciting fights on the card, and I can't wait to stand in the middle of that cage and call them out. Go to officialxfc.com for all the info. Catch it live on AXStv Friday, September 6th. Main event time. We're bringing you a sick fight. It's Ricky Rainey's last XFC outing against Reggie Pena only a month ago at XFC 24. It's our MMA Inside the Cage main event of the week.
Any questions from you, Blue? Any questions from you, Red?
John Huntsman with the final instructions. Team Pena is out in force here tonight at the Sun Dome. Red t-shirts everywhere, screaming ladies going nuts, and a couple of screaming dudes as well. Pena comes in the favorite, minus 190. Fight. The comeback of Rainey at plus 150, and Pena explodes out of his corner.
Smart closing that gap on Rainey.
Rainey digs to the body, right hands. Knee from Rainey. Nice Pena inside. Looking for the takedown.
Yep, nice inside trip, but Rainey's balance, his athleticism can take over real quick.
Pena throws the legs up. No submission though.
Rainey did a good job posturing up and getting out of that right away.
Still inside a half guard is the sniper. Still to come here tonight, our main event for the lightweight championship. Hot Sauce Holtzman versus John Marlowe should be a cracker. That coming up next. Looping left hand from the sniper, Rainey gets two to the jaw of Pena. Pena looking for a way back to his feet. Inadvertently gives up his back, however.
Hey!
Rainey back to his feet, single leg here from Reggie Pena. Pena looking for a takedown to no avail. Nice knee to the midsection from Ricky Rainey.
He's just wanting a better starting point than what he's got. Rainey just keeps controlling him, lifting that underhook. Now he's got that tie clinch.
Beautiful knee to the liver from Rainey. Now Pena gets free. Back to center cage. Some swelling under the left eye of the southpaw, Reggie Pena. Rainey's going to throw his right hand down the tube, and he does just that. Hit the lead foot on the outside of Reggie's lead foot. Jump to that. Rainey shoots in again, single leg, can't get the takedown on that occasion.
Pena trying that inside trip again. He's got to circle him so that leg steps forward so he can hook it.
Oh, Pena gets caught! Pena's on rubber legs! Here are the uppercuts from Rainey! Oh, the big knee! Pena in a whole lot of trouble! Locks up a leg!
Pena got to get a takedown here, man. He's in trouble.
Ricky Rainey teeing off on Pena like a golf course. Another uppercut. A big gobsmacking right hand. Oh, the big kibosh. Meet me somewhere. Ricky Rainey pounds out Reggie Pena.
Fighters, promoters, fans, get hooked up. Send us your best knockouts and submissions by going to MMAinsideTheCageTV.com and clicking Get On Air.